Emma Bunton. What do you think about that?
Just looks. I need to learn the technique, I think.
Do you like wallpaper?
I like wallpaper.
You didn't think you
Spice
were coming...
Spice Girls had wallpaper.
Did they?
Yes,
Spice Girls
did.
Wallpaper?
Spice Girls wallpaper.
What, with the whole team all...
The whole team on there. My mum's still got a few of those.
Really? Yeah. A few rolls waiting to go?
A few rolls.
Probably a collector's item now.
Charlie's going to be looking for a roll for himself now.
Yeah. And now, Holly stayed with us for a moment because... Can we share something? Because Holly was once appeared... Was it a supermarket somewhere?
Glams it up ever so slightly. I dressed up as... Yeah,
I'm
it's really embarrassing.
On,
I really can't believe you're making me tell this on television. I told him in confidentiality.
No.
When I was very, very young, this wasn't last year or anything, we dressed up as the Spice Girls for charity in the shopping centre. I think I was 8, 9 years old. And yeah, we dressed up. We weren't very good, and it's really awful. And the worst part of it is I think that my mum does have video footage, but thankfully hasn't worked out.
Mum, get that video footage.
No.
We want to see
it. We want to see it.
Yes. Ever.
We need proof.
That dies with me.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Holly.
Thanks for making me.
You must get that quite a bit, do you? I mean, there's a whole generation. I know many generations now who sort of have a moment, a Spice Girls moment.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's so flattering and it's lovely. And I think now, especially as well, you're seeing a whole new generation coming through. So there's like, you know, 5-year-olds coming up to me going, oh, I love the Spice. And I'm thinking, how do you know? But of course, it's, you know, through parents. And it's just wonderful to see. And and it's so flattering when people kind of get dressed up as you. It's nice.
We'll talk a bit more about Spice Girls in a moment, but your new album is out, your solo.
Yes.
Let's have a little listen first and we'll chat in a moment. Something's taken over my heart. You've caught me in the moment of weakness. Boy, you had me from the start. Now all I want to taste is your sweetness. So what's the point in trying to fight it? You've got me in the palm of your hand. You can shake me down. You can wind me up. You can drive me crazy, baby. Please don't stop. I'm going out of my head. Need to feel your love. Way too much can never be enough. So baby, please don't stop. Oh, baby, please don't stop. Baby, please don't stop. You're doing the moves. Don't stop. No, you can't just stop.
I was doing the moves.
It's a whole routine going on then.
There was.
So there's quite a 60s feel, not only to the sound, I'm thinking, and also people looking at what you're wearing today.
Yeah. It's just something that, you know, I was brought up with lots of Motown music in my house. And so whenever I write music, lyrically and kind of melodies, I think I just kind of bring out that 60s in me. And I think it was a brilliant era, of course. But yeah, I just love that 60s sound. And there's quite a lot of that on my new album. So,
yes, and you have worked with some great people. There are some great people you're working with there.
Yeah, and absolutely.
Amongst them, Robbie Williams, Will Young as well.
Yeah.
How does that thing work? I mean, is this an ongoing chat you've had for a while and you say... You know, pick up the phone and say, "Do you fancy? You know, what do you think? How does
that work?" Do
you know
what? Well, luckily, good friends.
Of course.
And Will Young, yeah, I just called and went, "Hey, I'm doing a new album. Do you fancy coming and singing?" And he is adorable. We had such a laugh. In fact, it took us quite a long time to record that song because we were chatting and gossiping so much. So we were in the studio having lots of fun. And then Robbie Williams, the same. He's wonderful. We have duetted a few times, live gigs and stuff. And then I just said, "Do you fancy singing my favourite Spice Girl song, To Become One, on my new album?" And so, yeah, so we do a little duet on there of To Become One, which is lovely. I'm so pleased. This album's been quite organic. It's been very natural. The kids sing on it. My other half sings on it as
Your children
well.
Sing.
Yeah, they do.
How old are they?
7 and 11. And then Jade, my other half, we do a duet together. I couldn't let Mummy Bunton on it because she's got a terrible voice.
That shouldn't break. Can't they do things with it? Can't they change people's voices and things like that?
Oh, yeah, but you know.
So it's a real family affair.
It's a real family affair, and that's why it's so special to me. And all the songs that I love and mean something, they're all kind of just very important to me through my life, these songs.
So the jolt is going to be, am I right in saying that on Monday, you're not on your own anymore, you're not in the studio on your own.
No.
This is the rehearsals for the Spice Girls tour.
Yes, so they start on Monday, which is crazy because, you know, my album's out now, so I've been doing, you know, lots of things to do that. And then, yeah, straight into Monday, rehearsals with the girls, which I can't wait. I just can't wait. I'm a bit nervous that I'm not going to remember all the moves. because I've got a terrible memory. So I think I've got stop down. Stop's pretty easy, you know.
That's in your DNA, isn't it?
It's in my DNA, yeah. So I just can't wait to be back in the room with them, rehearsing. We've created the tour. So we've been, you know, hanging out for a long time. Creating the tour, getting the set list ready, making sure the fans will be happy with that. So, yeah.
Can I ask you the sort of elephant in the room question, which is there's been a lot of stuff going around at the moment in the press and elsewhere about the dynamic between you because of various stories that have emerged.
Yeah, always.
I mean, you're here now. You know, tell me, what's the real deal about how you are getting on and whether anything that's been said has created any awkwardness?
Not at all. And I think the thing is, you know, we've been in this industry for a very long time and we know how it all works. And we constantly talk on the phone. I think that's the most important thing. If something comes up, we're like, right, what's going on? And it's like family. We are like family. We talk about everything. We get it out in the open and it's just then it's done. And we can honestly, we are so tight that even people around me, even my family, kind of like when they see us together, it's like, wow, OK, there's a, you know, there's a connection there that no one else has really, and I can only speak to them about the things that we have been through.
That must be in, as you say, you've been through a lot during your career with them and on your own, whatever. That must be quite comforting that you know that whatever happens, you kind of that is intact. That sort of relationship is intact.
Exactly, they're like my sisters, and I just spoke to Jerry last night and Melby. You know, it's like they are my kind of connection, and so on Monday, it's like. I don't know. It's like going to camp.
Does it mean
going to fun camp?
Does that mean you're able to kind of sit back and maybe laugh at the stuff that everyone else is, you know, the headlines and whatever? Are you able to
absolutely. You know, absolutely. We just kind of it comes when, you know, when this happens and it's been amazing. It's been such a big, you know, when we sold out the stadiums, it was all incredible. And of course, we know that we're back in the, you know, limelight, so we're going to get those kind of headlines. But no, we are we're tight, yes. Luckily.
And on the moves thing, all the routines and whatever. So it's you in the studio,
yes.
And it's just going to be hard work and all that stuff.
Yeah, hard
ready for
work.
It?
I'm ready for it now. I'm ready for it. Yeah. So really looking forward to that. And seeing the show that we have created come to life is wonderful because you have all these ideas and, you know, you work with brilliant people. But it's nice to see it come alive. I can't wait. I hope you're going to come along.
I'd love to. I'd love to.
Good.
And your kids are going to go and see the show?
Absolutely. They can't wait. I mean, they're so into music that this is going to be the first time they've actually seen Mummy kind of be a Spice.
They've seen the videos and stuff, have they?
Seen the video. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I've made them watch videos.
I've made them
watch Spice Girl videos. But, yeah, first time they'll see us live. You know, my youngest loves Jerry, so I'm like pushed out a bit. But yeah, it's going to be really special.
Lovely to see you this morning.
It's
thank you very much.
Lovely to see you. Thank you.
Emma Bunton's new album is called My Happy Place. That's a place, Emma, where Carol inhabits every day doing the weather. She is our happy place. Isn't that right, Carol? Here we go. The love is coming from Emma. Oh. There you go.
Back at you, Emma, as well. Good morning. And say hi to Mel C. I'm still so jealous she did a duet with my Bryan Adams.
Yes, she did. I love that song as well.
Me too. Good luck.
Can we just say straight away, you've had a bit of a special moment this morning, haven't you?
Certainly have.
Tell us.
I'm walking on air.
Why?
I've just met Emma Bunton. Well, so have you.
Yes. Of course. But why was it so special?
Well, that was my entire childhood.
The Spice Girls phenomenon.
The Spice Girls phenomenon, yeah. And, you know, you just hope that people remember how big they were. It was such a kind of cultural moment. And I was 10 years old when it all happened, so I was right in the middle of it. And I just when I was a kid, my incentive to be... There's me. And there's Emma Bunton.
So go on, then. So what are you saying that moment in time sort of... Was that the reason why you went into performing?
Kind of, yeah. I just wanted to be kind of... Show business, for want of a better term, just seemed like such an exciting place to be back then, and I wanted to join it. And of course, when you're a kid, you don't really have a sense of things moving on. You just think everything's going to stay the same, and then one day I'm going to join it. And, you know, it's taken me all these years to become part of it in a kind of way and meet Emma Bunton, and now I just don't know where I can go from here.